Good afternoon, YouTube. Well, I gotta build a new set of bindings for the wife because I got her a new set of snowshoes. And we're gonna make them out of rubber. Actually, what I have is either a tractor tire or a backhoe tire inner tube. But any inner tube will do. Large inner tube, pickup truck tire inner tube will do just fine. Bicycle inner tube, not so much. So, on the paper here, this is just a scrap piece of construction grade masking paper that was left over from a job I did painting something, don't recall, but I just made a pair of lines across this way, 3/4 inch apart, and they are to give me an idea of the pivot point on the snowshoe. And then perpendicular to that, a single line so that I can try and make things centered. Now, I took some measurements, and the measurement over the toe here, at the pivot point of the ball of the foot, is eight inches. So I'm gonna mark that out here. So centered on 4 inches. Mark it 8. Mark it 0. Mark it 8. Mark it 0. And then 3/4 inches over. Actually, no, I don't want it to go that way. I'm going to come 3/4 inch back because we want to be able to. No, we're going to go that way. 3/4 inch. And 3/4 inch. So, now, from the pivot point back to the high part of the arch here was 2 inches. So you want to come back 2 inches here, and then from that point back to the heel is 7 inches. So we're gonna come back about 6 inches to give us a little bit of stretch to hold the boot in the snowshoe. Then behind that, we're going to want about 3 inches there. These boots are about 3 inches wide. Something round-ish. You cut these out of the rubber, you have to make certain that there are no jagged cuts made. No inside 90 degree corners. Nothing that will initiate a weak point where the rubber could rip. So now we want, basically we want a minimum size of 2 inches everywhere. So just mark some guidelines out here. Down here we're going to have a reinforcement that doesn't really need to be the full 2 inches. Just sort of eyeballing, centering it over those four marks. There roughly is our pattern for the snowshoe, or not for the snowshoe, for the snowshoe binding. And then we need a couple of reinforcement pieces for above this. So that should just about do us right there. Now make sure everything is exactly symmetrical. Which side looks better? I guess that side does. Back here, I'm going to make just a little but you can get a finger in or ski pole in to help pull back to get your snowshoe on. Reinforcement pattern. have done was bring out a push pin. Okay. Okay, so these four marks are where we're going to pass lace through to lace around this part of the pivot point. So we're just going to stick push pin through. Standard Mexican jumping push pin. These marks aren't crucial, but so, now we need to cut out two of these and four of these from our piece of tractor energy. Okay, so we're going to start just by cutting a chunk out of this inner tube because it's so big. That would be why we have a beet pellet sitting on the floor in the living room. There you go, guys, the mother of all Ranger bands. I suppose it would have been smarter to grab a silver Sharpie than a black one for marking on black, but sometimes you just gotta live with your mistakes and learn to deal with it. What did I do with that leather punch? Brought it out here. Oh. this cut out. There are other ways of making these rubber snowshoe bindings. Lonnie from Far North Bushcraft did a really nice tutorial on one that is folded and has a complete toe cup, which are actually better if you're going to be wearing boots with hard, aggressive treads, because they offer the rawhide of the boot a little bit of protection from the sole, or the rawhide of the snowshoe a little bit of protection from your the sole of your boot. Now, you've got to be really careful when you're cutting that you don't wind up doing a lot of these little things like this, because that creates a weak spot where they, well, these are, of course, these are just going to rip off, but where the tube could rip across. Oops, I'm going to lose that. See, I'm going through well away from where I want my cut to be, just so that my pierce-through point doesn't cause any ragged edges. Now, these are based on a design that was taught to me probably close to 40 years ago by my mother's best friend's father, Jack Cody, who is Buffalo Bill Cody's great-great-nephew. But this little idea for the hole at the back here came from something I saw on a commercial version of this when I was looking online to see if anybody had actually done Jack Cody's snowshoe harness in the past 40 years. Okay, so this is now done except for the holes to tie through. So we'll cut the other one and then get back to you. Okay. So, using a leather punch on a size that, with a size that is roughly similar to 550 paracord, maybe a little bit smaller, we are punching the last of our holes. Now, you probably could do this with a Weatherall, but because of the likelihood of rubber ripping when it is frozen solid, frozen almost solid, I really would suggest if you don't own a set of a leather punch that you should get one. But that being said, you gotta make do with what you've got. So if you don't have one, go ahead and try it without them. You should be able to get inner tubes for free. I got two of these from the tire shop down the road from me, and they thanked me for taking them away. So, now, if to attach these to the snowshoes, oh, all of your scraps, especially these little ones, little fine edges, you want to save those and throw them in your tinder pouch, because rubber is easy to light and an excellent flame extender that burns really hot and makes makes lighting a fire that much easier. And don't light your tablecloth on fire unless your wife's busy holding the camera and doesn't want to be heard on film cursing at you. So, I have no idea what the best length for these ties to be is. Just cut four pieces off at a foot, pass it through the reinforcement, through the inside holes, harness, through the big hole that the foot pivots through, and the hole right beside it on the in the web of the snowshoe, and the one that's through the toe hole goes in through the next long hole in the webbing, back through the harness, back through the reinforcing piece, and tie off with a square knot. Other side, same. I guess 1 foot is decent length. boot goes through. Through there. Pull back. And you're attached. So we'll cut away now while I mount the other one. Okay, so we have changed positions here. I'm now behind the camera. One. Okay, no snaps, no buckles. What do you think of them? Well, that's it for now. I will be doing another snowshoe video, probably immediately following this, on types of harnesses, followed by some outdoor actual use. So, that's it for now, and thanks for watching.